Hey guys, we're back. The hit and run did not work. If you're just now joining us, Nationals scored two. American we have scored one.
Cincinnati. Nationals on top of this one as we get ready for the seventh. But first, let's check out the game summary.
The steal may not go much longer. In to try it again. Daniel Murphy. He could throw the heat. I will say that. He does throw heat. We're going to save some skirts. You know, got to go bullpen. To put in. You. Mill relief pitcher.
Here's the 0-1.
Right down there.
Right down the middle for a strike.
0-2.
Yeah, that's another nice two-seamer right there. He's been able to manipulate that pitch all game.
To Daniel Murphy.
The hollow of the knee, getting a lot of ground balls and a lot of swing and miss.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. The next 0-2. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one.
I always say hitting's a process of elimination at the plate. I think he could go ahead and eliminate changeup. Two in a row, back to back. I don't think they'll
into
be a
the
third.
Nets dug out.
A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get it.
Well, I like
chance.
To do lefties. I like to throw any ball that like does its. Oh, off Castillo. And is he okay?
No chance to recover, and let's hope he's okay out there.
That was hit pretty hard. He looks cool.
In now is Anthony Rendon. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far.
That's like one of their first runners since the first inning, boys. And you guys are watching this.
Much going against this guy so far. This one, he's been pitching well. And one of the key numbers to look at,
I like
first
this.
Pitch strikes over 70% so far in this outing.
I don't know if this is the last bat or not, but trying to get a double play here. Down third, foul. Went right through a guy.
Murphy gets his lead at first, nobody out.
Trying to jam him. Did not work on the jam. Duvall there with the catch in the left.
Now ready for another.
Yeah, no, never mind. He's ready. So we're putting in. They're going to put him in the game now.
Here comes Brian Price now out of the Reds dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen as that'll be all for the starter this afternoon.
Kevin Quackenbush
comes on to pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh.
He'll pitch as long as he can.
Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there. Base hit.
And a three hopper,
and
four hopper to third.
No further
from
than second.
Shevler.
There are two aboard now.
Two on and one out.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out. And stepping in now is the catcher, Miguel
Montero. I don't hate the dude. But yet, one time we were with our sister, Paige. She,
he's ready. Here's the 0-1.
Chris Stewart's game because my dad kind of made her. Not made her, but yeah, she asked and he asked. We're not going to go to second with this. He asked and she said yes. We went. Miguel Montero had a game winning home run. Obviously, at the Reds, we really don't go to state.
Ready once again, Max Scherzer. We're at a chance now to increase his lead if he can deliver something here with two
high slider.
One ball, no strikes to count.
So if we can get the, if we can tie and get Scherzer out of the game, that'll be an out, close one, and gosh, so we need to take any kind of sort of energy from that and bring it into him.
Here's the second baseman, Scooter Jeanette, over two from him so far in this one.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy.
Purposely did that, too.
They're extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Really are. We can get a gapper.
And
if we can get a gapper,
swing, ball one.
We'll be fine.
Well, you're in trouble at the plate if you fall behind this guy.
Yeah, you are.
So that was a good job to hold up right there.
And jammed him. And that'll be out number one. Cincinnati Reds, Cincinnati Reds, Cincinnati Reds, Cincinnati Reds.
Perfectly as he puts it away for out number one.
Shevler.
Ready for another chance. Scott Shevler.
Yeah, he jammed him.
And a single for him so far. ready. Here's the first offering. And this is taken outside. One run, six hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far.
2-0. Just got Shevlin.
No strikes. Here he comes on 2-0.
3-0.
That's a great job of keeping your hands back. You could tell he was totally fooled. His hips started leaking a little bit, but he was able to stay strong enough with his hands. Not the
3-1.
And that's in there. 3-1. One out, nobody on.
50 pitches is Max Scherzer. The end of the gap. This would be cut.
And he will run this one down. Good read off the bat for the second out. Stepping in and ready for another shot. Adam Duvall. He was a double play victim last time around. Starts him out with a changeup on the plate for ball one.
Well, he's done a great job on the hill throughout this game, and it's something to be proud of anytime you can pitch a good game in this ballpark, especially when it's not your
home
ballpark.
He's starting to miss his spots as he gets later into this game.
And now a pitch on the way.
Three and oh. Last two hitters, he went 3-0 to each of the last two hitters.
So you're not up at the plate thinking he's going to walk you in this situation. You need to be aggressive and sit hard.
Is Max Scherzer just challenging himself now? Because literally, 3-0 pitches to the last two hitters. And then the last two hitters also swing at a 3-1 pitch. So, will Walker more really force him to swing the bat? Into the right center field, yeah. This will not be cut, it's gone! And Adam Duvall gets the Reds a tie ball game. And Scherzer's like, with his face, 2-2 Reds Nationals. Duvall, game time, home run. Scherzer battles back, but Duvall's not this time. Barely got over the wall, too. Tucker Barnhart. Bottom seven. Low pitch, but we're going to call a strike anyways. 0-1. Scherzer did not fall behind this time. He fell ahead. Barnhart fell behind.
Now, pitch on the way.
In the center, this will be out number three.
Left pop up. And that ends the inning.
So, Duvall hits a dinger to tie us up. He was seventh going into that at bat.
A speedy Trey Turner digs in now. He was a ground out victim last time up. And he gets ahead 0-1. Here's the pitch.
Really? You control the pace of the game. You do. You control the pace of each game. The games are about 45 minutes long if you play the game, or if you do lock on player, the games are 10 minutes long. And I like to give you the full action.
Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Comes set, here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Foul.
Late on that one as it's fouled off to the left side. Now a bunt attempt here.
Got him again, and Suarez contending for third baseman of the year with three
throwing
across the bodies today. I don't think this dude has ever faced Bryce Harper before, so. But he does get ahead on him.
0-1 count and the pitch.
And he'll get Harper flying out to Adam Duvall. We go to the bottom of the eighth. Game tied at 2. Oh, if we go into extra innings, I forgot to say. If we hit extra innings, we're going to go ahead and bring in for him Jesse Winker. Winker. Bring in a guy who has had go and bring in Robert Stevenson. He has pitched a little bit here in the majors. He started a couple games last year in some of the show. Ooh, a little bit of high strike there in my opinion, but called anyways. New pitcher, so neither starter will get the win on opening day.
Can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now.
Ball low, 1-2 to Jesse Winker.
The 1-2.
Lined it in the left for a single. That's a crucial leadoff single for the Cincy Reds.
So it's a leadoff base hit, and it makes for a good start to the inning for Cincinnati.
Man, that's surprising, Dan. This guy's flailing at stuff in the dirt above his head to get to two strikes in any ways in the Phillies.
Well, you would think after throwing two pitches out of the zone that he would triple up and throw a third one either up, down, or in and out, but that one right in the middle of the strike zone.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Billy Hamilton. He's got a hit in three.
Ooh, tried to get a, not sack bunt out, but tried to get a hit bunting hit. Couldn't get either of them, so 0-2 on Billy Hamilton. Has to swing away now. That's a single. That's going to get Billy to third and a run home. And the Reds have taken a 3-2 lead. I'm not sure what happened to the sound. Hold on. Quick minute. Okay. So a triple will get in Billy Hamilton. We'll get in Jesse, so we're going to hit the bullpen real quick. We're going to sit down him and put in Iglesias to start us off in the ninth. One pitch to Peraza.
One pitch on its way.
So definitely if starters were in the game up to the eighth, well, hey, the Scherzer was, but this game would go for a Reds win. So.
If he was able to keep his hands back a little bit, he might have been able to.
And Billy Hamilton drives in a three-bagger with an RBI.
The 1-2.
On the ground to third, barely got contact.
And there's one down. And gone.
Votto will be up, try driving his
so
first one of the year.
In the Reds half of the eighth. And standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch.
This will get him way out toward left field.
The move is Taylor.
And Billy will score, it's a 4-2 Cincinnati Reds lead.
And the run will score from third to make this a
4-2 Votto will sack fly RBI.
That insurance run late in the game. That run right there gives them a 2-1 lead
up.
Heading into the late inning.
4-2 Reds.
Set and the pitch.
Ball high. 1-0. Reds have made him throw more pitches in one inning than they did with Scherzer. 13 pitches so far in the inning. 14th right here.
1-0 home.
1-1. Reds being a little more patient now that they have a 4-2 lead, trying to get the pitch they need. They want.
The first pitch he obviously tried to overthrow, got under it, and it sailed on him a little bit.
That swing right there reminded me of a swing my friend James. I'm not going to call him his name, but I'm just going to call him Jay here. That called him Jay.
Ninth inning coming up.
Swing. He was like on the curveball. He was like, I had to just tap it foul because, well, it's curveball.
Takes the ball now in inning number nine.
Real settle Iglesias. We'll try to shut down the Nationals in the ninth. Right now, I did not expect us to be in the lead because. Well, one reason being, well, Scherzer was on the mound. Scherzer was on the mound. And three fans have left. Well, at least in the front really have. I don't know if it was they left before the Reds started, Reese kept the scoring going. Ball two, two and two to Max.
You can have some mess that you put on yourself. Hey, regardless if it's a mess that he's inherited or one that he's created for
that's
himself.
That's in the right. That's a single for Max Scherzer. I like closers that will shut the door. Well, I hate it when they allow base runners. They're not doing their job right.
One
and Iglesias, honestly, is not my favorite, but if anybody, like, if I can, if there's a trade for him for a closer, I'll take it. Good. It just depends on Iglesias' worker, also. If Iglesias is 5-0 with a 0.93 ERA and a seven saves. Five saves. And that's the game. And it was rough to start, but the Reds would win 4-2. And they're doing the little thing with the dab. The dab. There's nothing special going on titles. It's just going to be Reds. Okay. Highlight reel. Here you go. Harper doubled the center, one RBI in the first. This is what happened. For those of you that are just now joining, this Zimmerman grounded and deflected off shortstop Peraza. There you go. For a single. Zimmerman advances a second on the throw to the plate. Votto grounded to second base, one RBI, so Votto got two RBIs in the air. Okay, sorry, you'll have to rewatch all this part. I accidentally pressed X. Gonna let the controller down. This is torturing it for me, but okay. Just not that. Yeah, you already know what happened here. Nobody would get the win on the Reds starting pitcher. They would not. And Votto grounded it out to second. 4-3. One RBI though. 2-1. Next. We definitely didn't disappoint in this game. Well, for fans at least. Scherzer grounded out to third base to end the top of seven. That would start the third part of the video. That started the third part of the video, the top seven. This part. Bottom seven, Duvall homers to right, to center, right center, I'll call it. And that'll tie the game. And that'll put Scherzer out going into the eighth. That time, that would also get us something going. Hamilton tripled to center, left center, maybe. And center, I'm going to say. That's more center. Tripled to center. 3-2 Reds off that triple. Iglesias right there, as you can see, arms up in the pen. A double cut there. Throw not in time at all. Votto hit a sack fly to left, so Votto had a really good day, although he didn't get on. One RBI in the bottom of the eighth. Loud in the eighth. And then there's the double play in the ninth. No, wow. Everybody just left. Left. Field. SF7 if you're keeping score with it. Rendon lined out to the shortstop to end the ball game. And the Reds with the dub on opening day. Losing pitcher Sean Kelly 0-1. Kevin Quinsenbush 1-0. Iglesias 1 save. Exit post game. Confirm exit. Okay, confirm exit. So losing winning pitcher Kevin. Losing pitcher Sean Kelly. Told you. So no game tomorrow. And then on Saturday, well, next phase in draft is since 69 days. Saturday we will have a game. Reds will be back in the red jerseys. I think for the rest of the series. This game right here was the game I was going to be going to with my dad and my brother. That got rained out. I don't know if it's going to be the same weather for every game on here, but whatever. Our next MLB Network game is against the Cubs. Day one, it's a two-game series. Okay, so. So we have next three series is we have Cubs, Pirates, Phillies, at Phillies and at Pirates. Crap. Cancel. I think I just simulate some games. Where's the calendar? Advanced day, yes.
Inside the show.
No.
Manage.
Opening day is behind us, so let's look back at how the first.
Okay, I did not. Oh, accidentally pushed square. Steven Strasburg for them.
To your Saturday edition of Inside the Show, I'm Justin Allegri. Starting off in the National League East, the Chicago Cubs sent three balls into the seats as they took down the Fish in Miami 8-3. The San Diego Padres got 12 hits in this one as they had a walk-off victory against the Brewers 6-5.
So that'll end the day, guys. See ya, subscribe, comment, like this video. Adios, amiga.